This is Dr. Martin's supplemental lecture on membrane transport. I'm going to talk about several ways in which the cell moves substances across the cell membrane. Just a reminder that the cell membrane is composed of a bilayer of phospholipids. So I want you to think of it as a very, very, very thin layer of oil that surrounds the cytoplasm and separates the cytoplasm from the outside of the cell. Anything that's soluble in water is going to have difficulty moving across that membrane because of the oily nature of it. All right. I also need to add the proteins that are present. Just to remind you, and we'll talk about them in some detail a little bit later. They're very important. So the first type of membrane transport that I want to discuss is diffusion. And diffusion occurs in all sorts of locations, but we're going to talk about diffusion across the cell membrane, so we're narrowing it down. Diffusion is a passive form of transport, doesn't require any energy. It is a form of transport in which substances move from an area in where they're in high concentration to an area where they're in lower concentration. That's what diffusion. Diffusion is movement from high to low. Third, in the case of the membrane and diffusion, there's really only a few molecules that are able to cross by diffusion. And this is because they're very small. Oxygen and CO2, these are the what we call the respiratory gases. Are able to cross the membrane through diffusion. So they go from a high concentration to a low concentration. A fourth set molecules is actually water, although people have found a channel that's called aquaporin, through which water will travel, but again, it moves from high to low concentration. Some people think that water can actually move through the membrane without this receptor, without this channel, but that's under debate. All right. There's a couple of special categories of diffusion. We can talk about osmosis, which I'm actually going to do a separate video on that, but that is the movement, we'll say diffusion, the diffusion of water across cell membrane. So because I'm using the term diffusion, remember that we're talking about movement from high to low. So again, this I'm going to talk about more later. There's another category of diffusion, and it is called facilitated diffusion. And it is, the term facilitated means to assist or to help. And so this is a type of diffusion that is assisted or helped by a membrane protein. So this is also a form, so no ATP is needed. We do move substances from high to low concentration, but we have to use a membrane carrier molecule to move from high to low concentration. So it does involve a change in the shape of the protein. So a substance might bind right here. That causes this protein to change shape so that now all of a sudden it has perhaps a little channel through it. And now that molecule, if this is in high concentration out here, can move across, and then that protein will go back to its previous shape. So that's called facilitated diffusion. There are other categories that we will mention here. There is a form of transport. It's called active transport. And the term active implies that some energy is required. And that is true. ATP is required. It does involve a membrane. Transport protein or membrane carrier. And the unusual feature of this type of transport is that we're going to move something from an area of low concentration to an area of high concentration. Many of the proteins, the transport proteins that are involved in active transport, some of them have been characterized, and they're usually referred to as pumps. So the transport protein is referred to as a pump, again implying an active role. And one of the most important is a transporter called the sodium potassium ATPase, or we sometimes just call it the sodium potassium pump. So it's actually going to move both of these substances across the membrane. And it does use ATP in the process. And this particular transporter is found in muscle and nerve cells, and it actually uses up quite a lot of ATP if we consider all the ATPs that are used in any given minute. People have estimated almost a third of the ATP that's used is used for this particular transport, because it's important for, like I said, nerve and muscle. All right, let's continue. All right, another category, two methods of transport that we're going to talk about together is endocytosis and exocytosis. And both of these involve the formation of a membrane vesicle and the substance to be transported is carried inside the vesicle. as you can maybe guess from the prefixes here, exocytosis is going to involve the movement of a substance out of a cell. Endocytosis is going to involve the movement of a substance into a cell. All right, so let's take a look at each of these in turn, in a little more detail. To illustrate exocytosis, we're going to look at a nerve cell. Nerve cells are, sorry about that. Actually, let me continue that discussion on the next video.